Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Monique Renee and this is my art channel. If you're new here, welcome. Today's video is super fun because I am doing a collab with the amazing Sophia Lou here on YouTube. Now, if you guys don't know who she is an amazing artist. I've honestly looked up to her for such a long time. She just makes the most beautiful illustrations. Her work is so detailed. She has so many fun projects that she's doing too. Like she's doing a comic called Plant Witch, which I'm really excited for. It's about a witch who does plant magic and she has a little cat named Prickles who's like a little cactus cat. Her work is so adorable and so inspiring to me. And I was so excited when she wanted to do a collab with me. Another thing that she was doing, this is the last day of Mermaid, by the way, so happy Mermaid. I hope you guys had fun. But she did, she participated in Mermaid and she did 31 mermaid illustrations and made a little mermaid zine. And her work is so beautiful. Like she did all of her work on tone tanned paper and the colors are so beautiful. And like I said, her work is so detailed. It's just, it blows my mind. So please go check out her work. Go check out her mermaid zine. Go check out her videos. Go just follow her everywhere. She's amazing and I love her and she's so sweet. And yeah, so she wanted to do a mermaid themed collaboration. And after some talking, we decided to do fan art. And what we came up with is I wanted to draw Princess Serenity from Sailor Moon and she wanted to draw Rose Quartz. So we each drew those characters as mermaids because it's mermaid. And it was so much fun. Like I had so much fun designing Princess Serenity's outfit and how it could incorporate that into like her tail design. And it was just, it was so much fun. And then the way that she drew Rose Quartz, guys, you will see in just a little bit. Oh my God, she did such a beautiful job. And for those of you who know Rose Quartz, she has like this crazy, huge, curly hair. Oh my God, she just, I don't even want to know how long it took her to draw all of this hair, but it's so beautiful, so detailed, and honestly, it was kind of a pain in the butt to color in because there is just so much of it, but it was so fun to do, and I love how it came out. I love how our styles kind of mesh together, and I absolutely adore the way that she colored in my lines for Princess Serenity. Like, the way she colors is so beautiful, and I was kind of worried because Princess Serenity had, like, her character design has a lot of white in it, and I find it very difficult to color in white because if you don't do it right, it kind of looks just like plain or not like not value enough, and it just I struggled with drawing white things. So the way that she colored in like the tail especially is just so gorgeous, and I'm just so hyped for this collab, guys. It was awesome. It was so much fun, and like I said, she's so sweet and just, it was great. It was so much fun. So anyway, now I think I will talk about the actual art for a little bit. So like I said, I am drawing Princess Serenity from Sailor Moon because I thought that she would make a really fun mermaid concept character. I wanted to play around with my character design skills and I wanted her to resemble Princess Serenity but also look new because she's like a mermaid. But anyway, it was a lot of fun. What I did was I sketched out the original sketch on paper because I always find it easier to get my ideas down if I'm drawing on paper. And then to do the actual lines, I took a photo of the concept that I had and then opened that photo in with my iPad on Procreate, and then I refined the sketch a bit more and kind of like added details, fixed some of the anatomy issues, stuff like that. And then I went in with a new layer and I started inking because what we did was we swapped line art. So I needed to have like a really solid line art. And I thought it would be a lot easier to do digitally. So that is what I did. And I just took, oh gosh, I think it was one of the pen tools in Procreate. And I started off with everything the same line width. And then once I had all that down, I went in and added thicker line weights to make the line art more interesting and details and stuff like that. And I really had trouble with the hair. For some reason, I just could not get the hair, her like pigtail things to look right. So I really struggled and drew them like 4 or 5 different times. But I am really, really happy with how it came out. I think she turned out pretty cool. And then I struggled a lot with the background too, because I don't even know. I didn't have an idea for the background, and my original idea was just to have like the moon behind her, but I thought that was a little bit too boring. Plus, she's a mermaid, so it wouldn't really make sense for her to be like floating in space with the moon because she's a mermaid. Anyway, so I just played around with a couple different concepts, and I liked the circle background that I had for the moon originally, so I kept that. And instead of making it the moon, I just kind of made it like a little underwater scene. So I added some like underwater plants and some fishes and stuff like that, just to make it look like she is in an ocean setting and not just like floating in space. And I do like how that came out. I think it looks pretty nice. And like I said, the way Sophie colored everything was just like, like amazing. Like, you guys have to go check out her half of the video. I'm not going to show the finished piece of hers in this video, so you guys will have to watch it and see for yourself. But yeah, just amazing. Anyway, so yeah, those were my finished lines, and then I got to work on coloring Sophie's lines. And what I did for that is she sent me a scan of her lines. And what I did was I took that in Photoshop and lowered the opacity down. Because the way I work with watercolor is I usually don't have solid black lines. And I kind of wanted to keep that because that's kind of like, that's my style. That's how I kind of work. So I wanted to keep that so that even though I'm using Sophie's lines, it would still kind of look like my style of coloring. So what I did was I lowered the opacity and printed that out onto watercolor paper. And then I did a really light wash of color on top of it. And I had to be a little bit careful because I let this sit for days before I touched it to let the ink dry. And even with letting it sit for a while, some of the ink still bled in places. In the finished painting, you can't really notice because I cover it up. But I just had to be careful not to use too much water and be careful of areas that just had like a lot of that ink laid down. So yeah, so I put in a light wash of color. I didn't add too much value here because I did a lot of work with color pencils afterward. So I just wanted to get like the main colors down, and I wanted to put in just like a little bit of shading, a little bit of value, just so I knew like what I wanted to go in and make darker and stuff. And then once I had the solid colors down, I went in with my Prismacolor colored pencils. And this is where I basically traced over Sophie's lines. So even with the light wash of watercolor down, those lines still showed through. So that's why I didn't like change the opacity too low and it wasn't too dark, so you could still see the lines. And then I went over it with the colored pencil. That way the line work wasn't black anymore, but it was the color of the color pencil. Because I wanted to preserve her line work because, like I said, her line work is beautiful and detailed. So I really wanted that to shine through as well. So I painstakingly went through every single line that she had that I could see, and I traced over it, and I added value in some places, highlights in other places. And like I mentioned, going through this hair, oh my gosh, I think it took me at least 2.5 hours to color all of that hair. And there's a pretty big time skip because I didn't want to record all of it just because it was taking so long. But I love the way it came out. Like, I don't know how Sophie does this for all of her pieces because it takes forever, but oh my gosh, the payoff is amazing. And I love looking at this piece because I can see her style in it and I can see my style in it. And it makes me really happy because I think our styles work really, really well together. And I just love the final pieces so much. I love looking at them side by side. It makes me so happy and proud. And I'm just so excited that I got to do this with her. And yeah, I cannot talk up this collab more because it was just so much fun, and I love the end results like so much. But yeah, so I went in with the color pencils. I used quite a few different ones, especially for the hair, because that's where I added most of my value, and this is kind of where I've been going lately in my direction with art. Where I lay down the flat colors with watercolor, and then most of my value I get from the color pencils. And I'm really digging how this looks. I think it looks better than my other pieces where I did solely watercolor, because value is something that I really, really struggle with. And I think it's easier to get those darks when you have color pencils, because watercolor is a pretty light medium. It's kind of, at least for my colors, at least, they're pretty pastel-ish. And it's really hard to get those dark, deep values without it looking muddy or without losing some of the saturation. So it's a lot easier for me to add value with those color pencils. And I love the way the end result looks. I've just been super, super digging it. But yeah, so that is what I did. And then I colored in the rest of her tail. I wanted to keep her colors very rose quartzy because Sophie did a great job of incorporating Rose's dress into the tail design. So I wanted to keep that and keep the colors consistent as well. I was worried that it was too pink, and I still think it might be a little bit too pink, a little bit too overpowering. But I also didn't want like her to get lost in with like all the details, and I wanted to make those crystals in the background stand out a lot because I thought it was really cool how Sophie incorporated the crystals in with like the oceany background. I don't know, I love how she just like drew the little environment around her, so I really wanted those crystals to pop. I do think maybe I should have brought more blues into the piece somewhere. I kind of struggle with color too, so I think if I had, I don't know, maybe more blue in the background or maybe some green, it would have maybe balanced it out a little bit more because this piece is very, very, very pink. But I think that's something I'm just going to have to work on and study a bit more because color is something that just doesn't quite click for me. It's something that I really struggle with. So anyway, yeah, that's pretty much all I think I have to say about this piece. Thank you again to Sophie for doing this with me. It was so fun. I really appreciate her doing this with me. And please go check out her work. I will have all of her stuff linked in the bottom below. I honestly cannot talk up her work enough. She inspires me all the time. She's also part of the YouTube Artist Collective, and she blows me away with like every single piece that she does because it's so beautiful. And she does an amazing job of like creating a story within a single illustration. And that's something that I really admire about her work and something that I want to bring into my own work. Her level of storytelling with illustration is incredible. And yeah, so that's, yeah, I'm gonna stop I'm really excited, guys. I'm really happy that I got to do this because I admire Sophie so much. But yeah, so that's all I'm gonna say for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys go check out Sophie's channel and see how she colored my Princess Serenity lines. You guys will not be disappointed. She did an amazing job. And yeah, I hope you guys have an amazing day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.